So I am to find the program to find the maximum element from tuple. In front of you, I have initialized the tuple with the name T. Okay. And I have taken mixed values. So here I would like to print the original tuple first. Original tuple print T. Here I am printing original tuple T. I give space over here. Now I am to find the length of the tuple by using len function, and whatever is the length of tuple, I assign the length to a variable x, right? I am taking one variable max. Let me MB a capital. I'm taking one variable max and I am assigning the value of first index to variable max. What is T of 0? Anybody can tell me? What is T of 0? Yes, Riddhi.
So 10.
10. T of 0 is 10. मैं ये assume करके चल रहा हूं कि जो मेरी पहली value है वही highest है. I am having this assumption that my first value is the largest value. Right? So I am starting the for loop. From first value. Why I am starting the for loop from first value, first index? Yes, please. मैंने one से शुरू क्यों किया? मैंने zero से start क्यों नहीं किया? Who will tell the reason for that? 11th class. Till you will involve yourself in the programming, you won't be able to clear your concepts. Why I have started the for loop from one, not zero? Yes, Samriddhi. Unmute yourself, Samriddhi.
Sir, because we have assumed that in element lying at index zero is maximum.
Yeah, of course. Good. We have assumption that first index zero is the highest value. जब मैंने अपने zero index की value max में already डाल दी है, तो I am starting my for loop from the second value. Second value signifies one. If tuple of I is more than max, what is T of I? I is one. T of 1 is 3. अगर 3 की वैल्यू 10 से ज्यादा है, मैक्स में क्या आ चुका है? मैक्स में आ चुका है 10. T of I means 1. T of 1 means 3. अगर 3 10 से ज्यादा है, if condition is true, then assign the new value to max variable. But 3 is not more than 10. Condition goes fake. Okay. 4, I 2 ho gaya. T of 2 pe pada hai 4. 4 ko max se compare karo. 10 se compare karo. Condition true nahi hai. To ye nahi chala. Then is 25. T of 3. T of 3 pe pada hai 25. Compare 25 with max. Max is 10. 25 more than 10. Yes. Condition is true. Max will be replaced by 25. Then proceeding with the next value of I, 4. T of 4 is 67. 67 compare with 25. Condition true. Max goes update with 67. Then T of 5. T of 5 is 89. 89 more than 67. Yes. So max get replaced with 89. Then comes only 9. 9 is not more than 89. So condition is false. 27 not more than 89, false. 34 not more than 89, false. 98 more than 89, true. So it get replaced with value 98. Then 56 is not more than 98. So finally max is 98. Come out of the loop. Print maximum value in tuple is max. Okay, got it? So save this program. 10 0 1 2 2 tuple max. Run this code. Check the output. All of you check the output. Is it clear to all? Yes, class. So transfer this program also in the practical file. If you have not done earlier in the practical file, transfer this program to practical file. Have you done it earlier? Somebody please come on the video and tell me. Have you done this program earlier in practical files class? All right. So now I'm going to discuss one topic with you. Okay. Sorry. Just a minute, class. Yeah. Is MS Word page visible to all? All right. So from this is the last chapter of your term two. Okay. Cyber safety. Already you have done few topics in your 9th and 10th class. Few additions are there. Okay. So daily I will be discussing programs and output question from tuple dictionary, and 10-15 minutes I will be discussing this theory chapter. All of you please pay attention very carefully. Okay, some new terms will be come, right? And I'll be asking questions from you also. So be alert. I will be asking questions in between from any child. Digital footprints. The first concept is digital footprints, right? Okay, in general sense, the footprint means nishan, your traces, your marks. हम कहते हैं ना, जैसे नॉर्मल भाषा में हम बोलते हैं ना, अपना निशान छोड़ दिया. वी आर लीविंग आवर फुटप्रिंट्स, वी आर लीविंग आवर ट्रेसेस, राइट? व्हेन वी आर वर्किंग ऑनलाइन, व्हेन वी आर एक्सेसिंग इंटरनेट, वेदर वी आर डूइंग एनी ईमेल, वेदर वी आर डूइंग चैटिंग, वेदर वी हैव ओपन एनी वेबसाइट फॉर एक्सेसिंग एनी डाटा, ओके? You leave your footprints, you leave some records, you leave some traces behind that recognize that you have done something online. Theek hai? Those traces, those records which are left behind after you have done work online, they are called digital footprints. You have done some shopping from online Amazon. You have done email to your friend. You leave some traces behind that identifies that this particular user has done this activity at this time. Those traces are known as digital footprints. There are two type of digital footprints, active footprints and passive footprints. Any online activity that is done intentionally by you, okay, those footprints which are formed online and it is done by user intentionally, that is called active footprints. Okay. You are doing email to your friend, or you are responding to some post by your friend. Aapke friend ne aapke status par koi comment dala, and you are replying to that comment. You are very much intentionally doing some work. Knowingly, you are doing some work. That time, what footprints are left behind? They are called active footprints. Okay, then is passive footprints. When footprints are left behind for the online activity and with the activity is done by the user unintentionally, unknowingly, unintentionally. Okay, that is called passive footprints. Then your concept is digital society. As we all know that technology is getting advanced day by day. New changes, new softwares, new hardware devices, softwares, and other technological resources are coming into existence day by day. And we, the members of the society, we are incorporating those technological changes in our daily life. Okay. Like we are having online teaching now. Due to lockdown, we are having online teaching. We are using Zoom platform. We are discussing e-notes. We are using Python online. Okay. Then you are interacting with the teachers by using different type of platform, Zoom, Google Meet, right? So all these technological resources we are using day by day. You are using smartphones. You are using tabs. All these technological devices, they are comprised under ICT, Information and Communication Technology. And the society, which is formed, which is created by the use of ICT, that is called digital society. Okay? You are chatting with your friend on WhatsApp. You are accessing Instagram. You are communicating messages. You are sharing photographs. You are sharing videos on Instagram. You are putting your status on Facebook. You are interacting with the public. You are online. You are using technology. You are using internet. You are working online. You are working digitally. So technology becomes integral part of your life. Okay, and the society which is adopting these technological resources, that comes under digital society. Meaning is clear? Eleventh class, be alert in this theory chapter. It is pretty lengthy chapter. Okay. Total, there are three chapters and all the three chapters are merged into one chapter. So be very alert when I am telling you the meaning of these terms. When you will thoroughly understand the meaning, it will be very easy for you to read the e-notes. If you are not following what I am saying, it will be highly difficult for you to read the e-notes. Aapko kuch bhi samajh nahi aayega fir. Theek hai? I am converting all the topics into easy language so that when you read at home, you will find it easy. So digital society reflects the growing trend of using digital technologies in all spheres of human activities. almost in every area we are using technology. We are at home, we are working from home, we are using computers, you are having your coaching classes online, you are using computers, you are using smartphones, you are using WhatsApp for checking the messages, checking the updates given by the school, given by your tutors. So we are in the digital society, okay? But when we are online, we have to follow some protocols. Like aap log school aa rahe ho, theek hai? As a student, you are bound by some rules and regulations. As a student of the school, you are bound by the rules and regulations of the institution. At home, as a child, you are bound by the rules and regulations framed by your family. Ki ghar mein kaise rehna hai, kaise apne bado se baat karni hai, how to respect your elders, how to behave in the school, how to respect your teachers, how to respect your parents, how to respect your elder brothers, sisters, younger brothers, sisters. Usi tarah se, when we are online, when we are working digitally, we have to see that our behavior towards online people, towards online second person, should be a good behavior. We are to check our safety also, that we are accessing internet in a safe mode. We are not prone to any risk. ऐसा ना हो कि हमारे साथ कोई मिस हैपनिंग हो जाए ऑनलाइन. Our image should get ruined online. We should be very much safe, very much alert about whatever we are doing online. Okay, clear? So such protocols, such etiquettes, we are to follow when we are online. And as we are accessing internet, as we are accessing digital things online, we are called as netizens, digital citizens, or we are known as netizens. Netizen means we the users who are using internet. Clear? So how we are abide by the rules? In three categories. Net etiquettes is the first category. Net etiquettes, by name it is very much clear. What etiquettes, what manners, what protocol, what rules you are to follow when you are working on internet. Net means internet. Clear? Be ethical. First is be ethical. Aap ek cheez note karo. मान लीजिए आप एक लेक्चर ले रहे हो, ठीक है? आर यू ऑल हियर इन द लेक्चर? ना प्लीज गिव योर फीडबैक टू मी सो दैट आई कैन नो हाउ मेनी आर लिस्निंग द लेक्चर केयरफुली. आई एम स्क्रॉलिंग थ्रू द विंडोज टू सी हाउ मेनी थम्स आर अप. ओके, आई गिव वन लाइव एग्जांपल टू यू और उस एग्जांपल को आप इस पॉइंट में ले आना, आपको ये पॉइंट क्लियर हो जाएगा. मैंने आपकी ऑनलाइन क्लास ली है, मैं आपको पढ़ा रहा हूं. व्हाट आई डिड, मैंने आपको एक डॉक्यूमेंट शो किया, एक वीडियो शो की जो मैंने यूट्यूब से ली थी. आई डाउनलोडेड वन वीडियो फ्रॉम द यूट्यूब एंड आई एम शोइंग दैट वीडियो टू यू. मान लीजिए कोई पाइथन का प्रोग्राम है जो यूट्यूब पे बना हुआ है एंड आई एम टू डिस्कस दैट पाइथन प्रोग्राम विद यू वाया दैट यूट्यूब वीडियो. आई एम शेयरिंग दैट YouTube video with you. और मैं अपना लेक्चर रिकॉर्ड कर रहा हूं. लेटर ऑन what I did, I upload my recorded lecture on YouTube. They will fail to upload. They will give me copyright error. It will be copyright claim on me by the YouTube owners. Why? Because I try to use copyrighted material which belong to someone else. Without their permission, I try to use their work. Never use any copyrighted photo, any copyrighted video, because that belongs to someone else. The owner of that thing is somebody else. And without their permission, you are using it. it will be a copyright error. So we as a netizens should not download any such thing which is copyrighted. Okay, clear? Then share expertise. Share expertise. आपके पास बहुत अच्छी नॉलेज है किसी चीज को लेके, उसको शेयर करो, बट ऑन द कंडीशन यू हैव गुड नॉलेज, यू हैव डिटेल्ड नॉलेज अबाउट दैट टॉपिक. जैसे मान लो एक प्रोजेक्ट है बैंकिंग का, और दिवांशी कह रही है कि मेरे को ये प्रोजेक्ट डिस्कस करना है, मेरे को अपनी नॉलेज शेयर करनी है. दिवांशी शुड शेयर दिस नॉलेज ऑफ द बैंकिंग प्रोजेक्ट ओनली इफ शी हैज थोरो नॉलेज अबाउट द सेम. शी कैन डिलीवर अ गुड लेक्चर ऑन द सेम. शी हैज सफिशियंट मटीरियल टू शेयर. और ऐसी कोई इंफॉर्मेशन ना शेयर करे जो फेक है, जो ट्रू नहीं है, जो फॉल्स है. That should not be shared by her. She should not share any such information which is not true, which is having some confusion, which is unambiguous. ambiguous. The information to be shared by Divanshi must be true information, must be proper information and unambiguous. उसमें कोई भी बायस्ड एलिमेंट नहीं होना चाहिए. और सेकेंडली, सोसाइटी को उसके बारे में ज्यादा पता भी नहीं होना चाहिए. इफ सोसाइटी ऑलरेडी नोस अबाउट दैट थिंग, व्हाई यू आर शेयरिंग दैट? कोविड गाइडलाइंस है, एवरीबॉडी नोस, मेंटेन सोशल डिस्टेंसिंग, कवर योर फेस विद द मास्क, यूज अ प्रॉपर गुड सैनिटाइजर्स. इसमें नया आप क्या शेयर करोगे किसी के साथ? Yes, if you have some good guideline regarding COVID-19 precaution, which society doesn't know, and you think that this is a very good precaution, it will benefit the society, it is true, it is real, it is fact, then you share. Okay? I hope up till here my lecture is thoroughly clear and going with a very easy language. I hope no trouble to any child. I know theory part you people bit take very casually, but it's my humble request to be alert in this chapter. The language is bit technical in the coming terms. Then second is be respectful. I like to maintain my privacy. Achha, I have a question for you. How you maintain your privacy online? Where is Ashutosh Kalia? He is always online. I would like to ask this question from Ashutosh. Where is Ashutosh? He is not attending the class. No, he is not in the class. Okay. Divanshi, unmute yourself.
Yes, sir.
How you maintain your privacy online? As a computer,
we can
as
maintain a, it by
please.
We can do it by not sharing the personal pictures, like if we
okay, no sharing of personal pictures. Okay, what else?
We can protect it by not sharing our personal details, like for example of bank details and other details.
Yeah, okay, agreed. Agreed. What else? Very good. What else? Okay, let me give chance to Harnoor. Yes, Harnoor, please, you share your ideas.
Sir, ID private karke.
You don't share your passwords with your friends. Okay, agreed. What else, Harnoor?
सर सेम पॉइंट जैसे दिवांशी ने कहा कि बाय नॉट शेयरिंग योर पर्सनल पिक्चर्स.
गुड. वी शुड नॉट शेयर अवर पर्सनल पिक्चर्स, अवर पर्सनल बैंक डिटेल्स, our debit card number, our credit card number, our passwords with each other. We may prone to risk. When we are maintaining our privacy, we are very much cautious about our privacy. हम बहुत ध्यान रख रहे हैं अपने प्राइवेसी का कि हमारी प्राइवेट इंफॉर्मेशन आउटसाइड रिवील ना हो, वो प्राइवेट ही रहे. सिमिलरली वी आर टू रिस्पेक्ट द प्राइवेसी ऑफ अदर पर्सन ऑल्सो. यू शुड नॉट शेयर एनीथिंग विच हार्म द रेपुटेशन ऑफ अदर पर्सन. आपके पास जैसे आप किसी से चैट कर रहे हो, ठीक है, आपने उस चैट का स्क्रीनशॉट ले लिया. डू नॉट शेयर द स्क्रीनशॉट, डू नॉट मेक इट वायरल. इट विल हार्म द प्राइवेसी, इट विल हार्म द रेपुटेशन ऑफ सेकेंड पर्सन. इफ यू आर वेरी मच अलर्ट अबाउट योर प्राइवेसी, यू शुड रिस्पेक्ट द प्राइवेसी ऑफ अदर्स. हां, आपको वो चैट का स्क्रीनशॉट शेयर करना है, पहले आप अपने फ्रेंड से कंसेंट लो कि हां भाई हम ये शेयर करें. अगर आपका फ्रेंड कहता है यस देयर इज नो हार्म, इट इज वेरी मच जेन्युइन चैट, यू कैन शेयर, मुझे कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है, ये चैट किसी की रेपुटेशन को हार्म नहीं कर रही, ये ऑनलाइन के नेट रूल्स को ब्रेक नहीं कर रही, देन यू कैन शेयर. बट एनीथिंग विच हार्म्स द रेपुटेशन, विच हार्म्स द प्राइवेसी ऑफ द सेकेंड पर्सन, डू नॉट शेयर दैट वर्क. If you are respecting your privacy, you should respect the privacy of second person too. Is the point clear? Yes, class? Okay. Next is be responsible. There is one situation I am giving you, and I would like to know the answers of that situation. A person is a student. B person is the friend of A person. On some personal grudge, B person put very bad comments, very low level comments about A friend online. उसने A के बारे में कुछ गलत चीजें लिखी जो कि उसकी reputation को harm कर रही थी. B person tries to harass the reputation, the image of the person online by putting some defaming messages, by putting some fake pictures, okay? And A person get depressed about the same. What this situation is called? And is this situation a valid one? Is it recommended? Yes, Mayank, what are your views?
Sir, we will handle it firstly on our personal level by blocking his accounts.
I am not asking how you will prevent it. I am asking the only answer. Is it valid that you are putting comments and messages for defaming the reputation of someone?
No, sir.
Okay, this is the first answer. And A person got mentally affected. Wo mentally harassed ho gaya. What this is? What this is called?
Sir, online harassment.
Yes, second name. Second name kya hai iska? Cyber bullying.
Cyber bullying, yes.
Very right. Good. Cyber bullying. When we are online, we should not put any such message, any such photograph, any such content that harms the reputation, that makes some other person mentally harass, that depress the person, that ruins his or her image online. Aisa na ho ki aapke is activity se second person itna depression mein chala jaye that he or she finally decides to do something wrong to his or her life. Because वो इतना tolerate ही नहीं कर पा रहा, इतनी insult उसकी online हो चुकी है, उसकी reputation harm हो चुकी है, वो tolerate नहीं कर पाया. Some persons are very sensitive in nature. हम जैसे real life में, आप class में हो, आप लोग class में हो, offline class में हो, कई बच्चे बहुत sensitive होते हैं, उनके साथ हम ज्यादा मजाक करें वो mind करते हैं, क्योंकि उनको feel होता है, they feel humiliated in the class. ठीक है, आई गिव वन एग्जाम्पल टू यू, टेल मी विच सिचुएशन इज बेटर, टीचर इज टेकिंग योर ओरल टेस्ट और आपको आंसर नहीं आया, टीचर ने आपको डांटा, बहुत ज्यादा डांटा आपको क्लास में, आप बहुत ह्यूमिलेट फील कर रहे थे, बहुत डिप्रेशन में चले गए आपकी, मैंने एक आंसर नहीं दिया और मेरे को मैडम ने कितना कुछ सुना दिया, आप बहुत सारा दिन टेंशन में गए आप घर। सेकंड सिचुएशन, आपको आंसर नहीं आया, टीचर ने बड़े पोलाइटली बड़े प्यार से आपको मोटिवेट किया कि बेटा आपको आता है, आप कर लोगे, कोशिश करो, ट्राई करो, आप ट्राई कर लोगे, बहुत अच्छी तरह आपको पॉजिटिव स्पून फीडिंग की टीचर ने, और आप में इतनी ताकत आ गई, आप में इतनी एनर्जी आ गई कि आप बोलना शुरू हो गए। विच सिचुएशन इज बेटर, विच इज रॉन्ग, हु विल टेल? मयंक इज शोइंग द सिंबल ऑफ टू, हिमांशु, यस हिमांशु, व्हाट आर योर व्यूज?
सर वैसे सेकंड सिचुएशन बेस्ट होगी।
वैसे वैसे का मतलब क्या, तुम फर्स्ट को भी एक्सपेक्ट कर रहे हो?
नहीं नहीं सर, सेकंड सिचुएशन ही सही होगी।
वैसे वर्ड क्यों लगाया, वैसे वर्ड खतरनाक वर्ड है भाई,
सॉरी सर।
यस डेफिनेटली सेकंड सिचुएशन इज मच बेटर, आप अपने फ्रेंड को, टीचर आपसे प्यार से बात कर रहा है तो आप में एक एनर्जी आती है कि टीचर ने मेरे से बड़े अच्छे से बात की, मुझे टीचर ने रिस्पेक्ट दी, अब बहुत पूरा दिन आपकी एनर्जी रहती है और आप हमेशा घर आकर डिस्कस करोगे, आज ना मेरे को टीचर ने बड़ा बूस्ट अप किया, मम्मी आज मेरे को बड़ा अच्छा फील हो रहा है कि मेरे को टीचर ने मोटिवेट किया, मेरे को नहीं भी आता था ना, मेरे को आ गया। सेकेंडली आपको टीचर ने इतना ज्यादा ह्यूमिलेट कर दिया, आप और टेंशन में चले गए, सारा दिन खराब हो गया, ट्यूशन नहीं लगा पाए, पढ़ाई नहीं कर पाए, रोते रहे घर बैठ के, दैट हरास यू। सो वी शुड नेवर पुट आवरसेल्फ इनटू सच सिचुएशन वेयर बिकॉज ऑफ अस सेकंड पर्सन गेट्स हरास्ड, सेकंड पर्सन गेट डिफेम। ओके, द नेक्स्ट टाइप ऑफ एटिकेट इज communication etiquettes, how we are communicating on internet, this child is entering late in the class, how we are communicating on internet, we are doing email to the friend, we are doing chatting with the friend, we are sending instant messages, we are doing video call, we are doing audio call, all these things are communication medias, all these are ways to communicate. So while you are communicating with your friend, some etiquettes are to be followed. What are the communication etiquettes which you are to follow? Be precise. First of all, be precise. Seedha mudde ki baat karo. Come to the point. Don't waste your time in irrelevant discussions which are having no use. ओके, जो बात है, जो टॉपिक है वो डिस्कस करो, व्हाई टू बीट अबाउट द बुश, व्हाई टू गो अराउंड द टॉपिक व्हिच इज ऑफ नो यूज। आपने फ्रेंड को कॉल किया केमिस्ट्री का कोई फॉर्मूला डिस्कस करने के लिए, एंड यू स्टार्ट डूइंग डिस्कशन ऑफ द फेयरवेल पार्टी, व्हाट इज ऑफ दैट यूज, दैट इज ऑफ नो यूज। डिस्कस योर केमिस्ट्री फॉर्मूला, डिस्कस द टॉपिक एंड पुट द फोन डाउन, और इफ यू आर चैटिंग विद योर फ्रेंड, डू चैट व्हिच इज रेलेवेंट, not any irrelevant chat, are you there, I am here, what you are doing, I am doing this, no, come straight to the point, okay, be precise, right, respect data limits, you must be aware about the size of the file that you are sending, aapko pata hai whatsapp pe ek limited video file size ki video ja sakti hai, heavy size video cannot go via whatsapp, you have to compress that video if you want to send it to WhatsApp or any social media. So you should be very much aware about the size of the data that you are sharing with the friend. Okay, don't send any heavy files which unnecessarily consume so much of bandwidth. Clear? Then is be polite. Don't get aggressive with your friend. Don't get so much frustrated when you are discussing things online. Be very polite. Be very calm. Silently try to listen what other person is saying. Okay, don't just be always in the aggressive mood. सामने वाले की बात भी सुनो कि सामने वाला क्या कहना चाहता है आपको. You put your statement. Okay. Second person listening politely. When second person starts speaking, you should be polite and you should also give time to him. Yes, now you speak. I will listen to you. Okay. These are communication etiquettes.